availability of them two to do a presentation for us.
Yeah, I think part of the point you're making is we need to blow our own trumpets a little bit.
That's basically it. I mean, you didn't mention the agenda isn't settled, so I don't know if there's any leeway between now and the actual event to actually try and address that. That would be certainly welcome in mind, wouldn't it?
Certainly better to mind.
Yeah, I think you're right, we should blow up. But I think, you know, Merseyside Pension Fund, we're right up there and ahead of the rest generally, and I think that's a good way. So we'll follow up on that. Thanks for your comments, Pat. Okay, so in fact, Peter's going to carry on and give us a pruning update again, which mentions our pruning partners again.
Yes, thank you. Chair, the report provides members with an update on pruning arrangements. It also seeks approval for myself and the Borough Solicitor to conclude an inter-authority operating agreement between the three funds in the Northern Pool and the related constitutional amendments that might be required. Section 2 sets out the background, which is that we're looking to finalise the high-level governance arrangements around the joint committee and for that joint committee to function, an operating agreement is required. 2.2, we've made some good progress in terms of pooling around alternative assets where our focus has been. That's in two particular areas so far. One is around infrastructure investment and the other is around private equity, where we have undertaken collective investments with the two other funds in the Northern Pool, and they've certainly been good in terms of reducing investment costs, and we're confident that they should deliver good investment returns for us over the longer term. Under section 2.4, some high-level summary of the responsibilities intended for the Joint Committee, which are set out over the page on page 76. The Joint Committee is to provide monitoring and oversight of the pool, to report back to the pension committees of the participating authorities, and again, as a conduit for pension committees to reflect their views back to the Northern Pool. There will need to be clear separation of duties between elected members on the Joint Committee and officers of the pool, and then finally around monitoring performance and again monitoring the appointment of investment managers. Section 2.5 just clarifies that the Joint Committee won't be undertaking any regulated activities, which is in line with the guidance that MHCLG has issued. In terms of Section 3, relevant risks, pooling will result in fundamental changes to oversight and management of LGPS assets. It's therefore important that this committee satisfies itself that appropriate governance arrangements are put in place. So under section 13, the recommendation is that members note the pooling report. And secondly, I'm seeking approval to work with the Borough Solicitor to conclude an inter-authority operating agreement between the three funds. And any constitutional arrangements that may be required. I think we should revise the recommendation to indicate that that's subject to any necessary approval by the council. Thank you, Chair.
Particularly related to the constitutional changes that are required, so they have the committees there all the time, and the approval of the council.
Yeah, on that point, I think that is important because I'm happy for Peter and Colin to actually reach a draft agreement, but particularly if there are any constitutional amendments, it's got to go back to the council, but I think that needs to be reflected in perhaps an amendment to the second part of the year recommendation. And if so, I'd be happy with that, Chair.
Thanks, Chair. I think obviously we need to take into consideration any additional risks as well in terms of Brexit and climate change as well.
So we are looking, it is important that we clarify our position and that we separate duties, particularly there are concerns from central government about members being involved in investment decisions. We're clearly not.
committee approved attendance by the chair and party spokespersons at the LAPFF conference, which is in Bournemouth from the 5th to the 7th of December. MPF is a member of LAPFF, indeed the chair is a member of the LAPFF executive. It's a very useful conference addressing topical issues around sustainability, around stewardship, around climate change, and a number of indeed around pay and remuneration. The appendix is the agenda for the event. It commences on a Wednesday afternoon, concludes on a Friday. Clearly it's for committee to determine attendance. Section 8 confirms that the cost is £500 a head with travel and accommodation an additional cost. But there is training is an important element of membership of this committee, and there is a budget available for that. So members are asked to consider attendance.
Okay, so obviously I'd recommend the conference because I'm on the agenda. So I'll be doing a bit of a presentation myself, a bit of song and dance routine. So I would recommend the conference anyway for myself and party spokesperson and anyone else who feels they like to attend. So happy to note that recommendation. Okay, so agenda item 8 is our annual college conference. Again, Peter will talk us through the arrangements for that.
This format in December can be a bit bleak, but as an alternative, as entry in November, where we have our annual college conference. It's a morning event commencing about 10 o'clock, finishing around about 1 o'clock. It's a useful summary of the key activities of the fund. We'll have our actuary speaking, we'll have a spokesperson from the local government association. I'd encourage members to attend if at all possible. Thank you, Chair.
Again, I'd like my support to that. It is a very, very good attendance, not just a good location and nice London, but the presentations are very good and it gives us the opportunity to meet with our counterparts from other authorities and also officers from the employers within the fund as well. So it's a good day if you can make it. So happy to note that report. Okay, so our next agenda item is the local pension board minutes. So,
yes, thank you. As the report states under 2.2, the local pension board provides reports to the administering authority on its activities, and as part of that reporting, the minutes of this meeting are shared with the pension committee. So those minutes are attached as an appendix to the report and just confirm the matters considered by the pension board and any recommendations that they have for committee. There aren't any on this occasion. The members are asked to note the report and to note the minutes.
So happy to do that. Thank you. Agenda item 10 is the Local Government Pension Scheme Governance Conference, again, which Peter will talk us through.
Thank you, Chair. This again requests nominations to members to attend the LGPS Governance Conference, which is in Bristol in mid-January. Attendance would help members in fulfilling the committee's knowledge and skills requirements. The programme is attached as an appendix to this report. Again, the cost is £515 per head with transport and additional expense. So members, for a committee, its committee is asked to consider who wishes to send a delegation, and if so, to determine the number and allocation of places.
I'm not suggesting this would make a decision on that now, but I'm sure this would be good event for our board members as well to attend, so Emma will circulate that, so we're happy to know the report otherwise and the recommendations. Yes? Okay. Agenda item 12, issue body applications. So again, there's an exempt agenda item on this. Otherwise, I'll ask Yvonne to just talk us through, please.
Before you do, Chair, I'm still on the floor.
Thank you, John.
Staff will transfer from Helena Partnerships and Liverpool